No questions?
Maxie, Bria Maranthus, Sports Illustrated Fan Nation. A new NBA season kind of feels like a new school year. So if the Mavs had a yearbook, what would you be? Like, best dressed, best eyes, most likely to be the president, or have your own TV show? Any ideas?
That's a really tough question. I feel like, first of all, I'm not allowed to answer that, but I would just be like, hopefully, good team player, good classmate, comrade, whatever.
What would Luka be?
I would say, in a funny way, a leader. Like, you know, he's obviously like very, very talented, but at the same time, somebody who like wants to have fun and joke around.
Best clown?
I didn't want to say clown. That's like has like a little bit of a thing with it, but yeah.
You're, you know, for lack of a better term, an elder statesman now on this team. I mean, as far as tenure, do you think it's going to be a challenge to, how big of a challenge do you think it will be with 8 new players, basically? And then you guys are about to go off to Europe on 12-day.
I mean, it's always a challenge when you have new players coming in, obviously. But I think we also have like a lot of experienced guys here that can help them out. And, you know, obviously the practice time is also limited when you travel. But I think a travel like this can also help and just bring the team together. And I think that's like one of the bigger important things to come together as a team. And everything else is solved by, you know, the chemistry and being able to communicate and also listen to each other.
Actually, what are your thoughts on the big guys? I'm right here.
Oh, sorry.
What are your thoughts on the big guys that's coming to the team this year? Rashad, Lively, and Grant.
I think they will help us a lot. You know, Grant has proven to be a very, very valuable player. I've watched Derek the last couple of weeks working out and his ability to finish around the rim, set good screens. You know, he understands the game really well. Is a great listener too, and is willing to improve and learn. And Rajat also, like, you know, very talented player, has proven to be very effective. So I think it's going to be really exciting to see how they all work together, and also with Luka and Kyrie on the court.
What happened to this team last season? Mm-hmm. How much of a chip is there on y'all's collective shoulders, and what gives you confidence that was just an aberration?
I mean, you know, obviously there's a certain feeling of that chip on your shoulders because last year was obviously very disappointing, but we want to move on from that and, you know, mentally focus on this season. I think we have a lot of talent and we have a lot to prove and to make up for. It's not going to be easy. You know, the league is really competitive and has a lot of good teams, but we believe in ourselves and we want to make up for what happened last year.
Maxie, do you envision that this team will be dramatically better defensively from last season's team?
Do I envision it as in, like, is it going to happen, or do you think that's like already, like, happened?
You guys are more of a scoring team, and
yeah.
It seems like with your personnel changes, there's potential here to be better
defensively. Yeah. Yeah, I feel confident about that. You know, we have a lot of guys that can play really good isolation defense, understand team concepts, and therefore can help other teammates out. I don't think we are losing anything on the offensive end, really, because, you know, we run it through Kyrie and Luka, and those are, like, one of the best to just do it. But, you know, on the defensive end, I think we did make some improvements.
Maxie, what was your focus in the offseason and just to get yourself ready going for this year?
You know, doing the same work. I want to make sure I'm physically healthy. You know, that was obviously last year not the case. And it's very frustrating if you can't be out there with the team and help. So the goal was to progressively increase the workouts to be ready for the long NBA season.
Is anything new that you were doing? or have you come up with a pretty good plan that you've been using the last
few years? Kind of both, because the injury from last year was not like an easy injury, because it doesn't really react sometimes the way that I wanted it to, especially when you work out, because there's like a different kind of soreness in there. So I had to get used to it and understand what happens and what to do and what not to do. But it's a learning process, like with all other injuries too, to just figure it out. But I want to just focus on staying healthy and, you know, then just in that role that I have for the team, be the best version and help.
Do you feel like you're fully recovered, or is there still some limitations for you on the court?
No, I would say I'm fully recovered.
What's your take on the new NBA in-season tournament?
It's going to be very interesting and fun, I think. You know, I think for that small section, we'll also like raise intensity potentially. You know, like in a lot of games, sometimes they can get lost because it is a really long season. But I think they will put a little spark in there and be exciting.
No load management that time?
I mean, you guys can discuss about load management, but I think everybody tries to win regardless.
Maxie, with so many new players, how much will this 12-day road trip really give you guys a chance to get to know each other?
Say again, the road trip? Yeah. I mean, it's a great chance because obviously we're, first of all, we're going to be stuck on an airplane, so we're going to have some time there. And then also once we get there, you know, there will be team activities, there will be team dinners. It's just like makes it easy to be with the team because probably it's less likely to have other people around there. So it's a good team bonding experience there.
Hey, Maxie, Noah Weber from the Smoking Cuban. What have you thought of working with the rookies so far and how are they settling in to working with y'all?
They're really hard workers. You know, they show a lot of character and attitude, so that's really good. And like I said, they're willing to learn. They're really good at listening and, you know, doing the little things that coaches and players ask from them. So I think they have a bright future ahead and if they keep going like that.
Yeah. Coach says that the team is more athletic this year. In the past, Josh Green, it seemed like he was the most athletic guy. Out of these new guys, is there anybody more athletic than Josh Green, or is there somebody we need to keep an eye on?
I don't know. Josh is pretty athletic, so you got to prove to me that you can beat him, especially when it comes to like running up and down. I feel like he has an endless motor and never stops. But we do have some more athleticism, especially when it comes to jumping. I mean, everybody knows that Derrick Jones Jr. can jump out of the gym. Grant, I would put him up there. I was just kidding. I can say that because I'm less athletic now too, but no, but like it will be a challenge to beat Josh when it comes to like running up and down the court, I think. Yeah. Sure, different position, so I would say it's a little bit different, but being a guard and covering as much ground as Josh does is really hard to beat. You can track the running distances that he covers. It's pretty impressive.
Maxie.
2 minutes left.
Maxie, being a rim protector has a lot of responsibilities and challenges for a 19-year-old like Derek Lively. What's important for him, you know, throughout his rookie season, and how can veterans like you help him throughout the 82-game season?
I think very important is to understand the positioning and what is expected in certain coverages, because obviously you can't defend everything at all times. You need the help from other teammates. And you have to trust your teammates, so you have to understand what is your part in certain defensive schemes and then just play those rules. Obviously, there's like exceptions every time at times where you just have to like go by instincts. But I think he has great instincts and already good positioning and understands it. And obviously, he has the length and athleticism to be very, very effective in those two.
What's your first impression of Dante Exum and how you feel like he can help the team?
Oh, he's a very calm presence, good teammate, and the times that we played, you know, he shows like leadership on the court with the ball in his hands, making smart decisions. So, you know, he left a really good impression.
This season's roster seems to have more size on the perimeter. You know, like defensively, how important do you view that compared to last season?
I mean, it's very important. I think first of all, you can cover more ground on the defensive end, and also it will help the overall rebounding issue that we had last year too. Just finishing plays, because I think a lot of times we had really good possessions, which is that didn't finish them. And I think with the length and the athleticism that we gain now this year on the bigs position, on the guards position, will help us to be more consistent than that.
Hey, Maxie, during your time with Dallas, we've seen you play both the 4 and the 5. This year, what do you expect to be playing more?
Got to ask Coach.
All right, thanks, everyone.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.